Hi, everybody. Matt Bernier joined by Mike Beard, taking a look at the Saturday DRF Bets race of the day, race number 9 at Indiana Grand. It is the Grade 3 Indiana Derby, a mile and a 16th on the main track. Before we dive into the field, I'd encourage you to head on over to drf.com/bet. Get all the latest details as far as a new DRF Bets account is concerned. Again, drf.com/bet is the address. Take a look at the field of three-year-olds that'll go 8.5 furlongs at Indiana Grand on Saturday night. You can head over to the Race of the Day page on drf.com, download free Formulator Pass performances, and handicap along as we go through the field in post position order. Mike, we start with the number one, Trigger Warning. This is a horse that two starts back, he really kind of blossomed going 6 furlongs in the synthetic. And then, as far as I'm concerned, I don't know where that Ohio Derby came from. What are your thoughts on Trigger Warning?
Yeah, I thought he ran great last time. Certainly, to me anyway, the best race he's ever run. And it's nice to see this horse at least finding his best form. His last three races, you know, very clearly the best races he's ever run. He got that wide trip at Thistledown last time. He hung in there very gamely all the way down to deep stretch. I thought he ran a great race last time. Do I think he can back it up in the Indiana Derby? I mean, I guess I won't be surprised if he does it, Matt, but he was 86-1 last time. I'm having a tough time wanting to go back to him in here, but I don't deny that he ran very well last time.
Yeah, it's the only thing for me. He was just such a long shot in there, and it kind of felt like it was out of the blue. But like you say, he's at least going the right direction. Now, I think something else that could work against him, we're going to take a look at the Timeform US pace projector right now. And you see that red bar down on the bottom indicating a fast pace, and they have the one out there being contested by the 4 horse, and the 7 is not too far off. So I think you're going to have a pretty lively pace situation. We'll find out if Trigger Warning can outrun his odds again here for 2 starts consecutively. The number 2 is Blame the Rider, coming in for Doug O'Neill. They are going to scratch from the race at Delaware on Saturday, and they're going to run here under the lights on the main track. I think his form is significantly better on turf than it is on dirt, and we have a negative formulator fact for Doug O'Neill. Past 5 years, turf to dirt, graded stakes races, 2 for 27 with an 88-cent ROI. Do you agree or disagree with my sentiment that he's just better on turf?
Yeah, I mean, especially with that formulator stat that you put up there sort of staring in the face. I mean, the only way you can really like this horse is if you think he's going to be able to transfer the recent turf form back over to the dirt. But to me, he just has that look of a horse who just really, really improved on grass. I don't really want him in this race.
The 3, Give Me a Minute. They tried that little bit of a turn back and distance. He had gone the 1 turn mile, 2 starts back, then 7/8 in the Woody Stevens. Neither of them worked out particularly well. The problem is I still think he's better going shorter.
Yeah.
Overall thoughts on him here?
Yeah, I think he's better going shorter too. It's, you know, it's sort of frustrating to see them just keep pressing on with this horse and all these graded stakes races, and now they're going to try and stretch him out again. I do think he has some talent, and I do think there's a chance at a pretty big price he could get a piece of this thing. I just didn't really want to bet him to win. I don't really see that one race that he has that's going to make him a winner in this field, although I think he fits pretty well.
Peter Urton ships in from Southern California, the number 4, Dark Vader. I've always been a little bit of a fan of this horse, but I have to be honest, and I'm curious what your thoughts are. You're the NYRA analyst. That Easy Goer, I understand you've had a couple of decent efforts coming out of it with Rugby Man running with an 84 in his most recent start, and the 6th place finisher earned a 90. I didn't like the Easy Goer, and I'm having a hard time liking Dark Vader here.
Yeah, I sort of agree with you, Matt. I mean, I didn't, you know, I liked Rugby Man out of that Easy Goer last time. And I know that he was in a tougher race last time in the Dwyer, but I just didn't think that he ran that great in his most recent start. So overall, I'm sort of trying to stay away from horses coming out of that Easy Goer now. Dark Vader, I guess he's competitive in here with his good race. I like that he has some speed. I think he'll be forward in here. I don't know. I guess it all comes down to price. I don't want to bet him, but if he's 8-1 and you like him, I'm not really going to argue too hard with you.
If you like the number 5, the Money Dance, you're hopeful for a form reversal because his 2 most recent starts, draw a line through the Arlington Classic. Yeah. Don't hold that against him over yielding turf. The most recent start against Indiana Breds, that was a bit of a disaster. But prior to that, you at least had some buyers that would suggest he was trending in the right direction. The problem is you've had those most recent starts. To me, he's a pass.
Yeah, I agree with that. I don't want this horse. He was on the cusp of making himself competitive with those 3 races before they switched him over to turf. I don't know what happened last time. He's 3-5 in a state bred race at Indiana Grand. He's just nowhere in that race. I can't take him off of that.
The number 6, Axelrod, is another one that comes in from Southern California. This one for Michael McCarthy. Most recently, 2nd behind Draft Pick. Draft Pick will be running out at Los Alamitos on Saturday afternoon. I think Axelrod is interesting enough. It seems like the 2 turns on dirt is probably what he wants. The question now is, do you think he can up his game again making another start on the main track.
It'll be interesting to see what happens. I mean, I do like that draft pick that sort of easily outfinished him last time, but I do think that's a pretty good horse heading the right direction. This horse I thought ran well last time. I also felt like he had a really soft trip in that race. The pace wasn't fast. He just sat right up there on it. Pace is going to be faster in here. I don't know if he's going to be able to cope with it, and he's not a great price on the morning line.
The number 7's title ready for Steve Asmussen. And early in the Oaklawn Park meeting, it looked like this was a horse that you could be penciling in as one of the key contenders for a race like the Arkansas Derby. And they tried to get him on the track to the Kentucky Derby. And then it kind of feels like things got a little bit rocky there for him for a little bit. I guess my question is, he also comes out of that Ohio Derby. I don't know what his best game is. I feel like he wants to be forwardly placed. But in a race like this, I would be terrified if he was too close.
Yeah, I agree with that. The pace situation might not really work for him too well. Ultimately, I still think there's a chance he turns out to be pretty good. I mean, he has run some good races. When I go back and look at the Ohio Derby, I'm not suggesting that he was going to win that race. I don't think that he was. But that trip wasn't perfect. I would just say that he was in a lot of traffic, sort of got into a tight spot in the upper stretch, and then he was racing on again at the end. I wouldn't have been surprised if he finished third in that race. So I think that was an okay performance. I allowed myself to be swayed by his morning line. I don't know if he's really going to be 12-1, but if he's going to be around that price, I could see him doing pretty well in this spot.
The morning line favorite's the number 8, King Zachary, for Dale Romans. He's 6-5 on the line. This is a horse that I've liked for a little while, but the problem is, and even I have to admit it, I don't know where the buyer speed figure came from that Matt Wynn, where he earned a 98. It's the highest last out figure in the field, and he absolutely destroyed that field at Churchill Downs. Now, I don't know what he beat in there. Axeman, it helps when the 1-2 favorite completely flops. Right. The question becomes, do you believe that figure? Because if you do, he's a major player. Otherwise, you're looking at a horse that really on paper is not fast enough to win.
Yeah, he's sort of a one-hit wonder right now. I did run really well last time, but it's sort of, I think I agree with the way that you're sort of talking about him here, is that it's sort of a double whammy with the Matt Wynn last time. Not only is it the first fast race he's ever run in his life, but it's also a race where Axeman just totally bombed there at a short price. And so it sort of leaves that race just open to all kinds of speculation, especially if he's going to be 6-5. But I've liked this horse from the start. I do think he has some talent, and I like that Romans is shipping him in here to run in this race. I do think he's the horse to beat, Matt.
Not going to get near that 12-1 that he was most recently. No. 6-5 on the morning line. And the last runner in this field for the Indiana Derby is the number 9 Funny Duck for Rusty Arnold. Most recently, he was waxed pretty good by King Zachary in that Matt Wynn. Yeah. 2 starts back, you have the race that I still have no idea what happened in there. The Pat Day Mile, he wins it 1,000,000-1 in that spot. Was it a one-off situation? Or is this horse, you know what, do you want to give him the benefit of the doubt and say draw a line through the Matt Wynn? Maybe he can improve.
Yeah, the only problem with that is I just don't know why you would draw a line through the Matt Wynn. I mean, it didn't seem like he had any real excuse in there. He didn't really do any running either. King Zachary just drilled him in there. And then you go back to the Pat Day Mile. That's the race that you could point at, I guess, if you like him. But to me, that's just one of those races. The horses that did well, I don't think you want to give them too much credit. The horses that didn't run well, I don't think you want to hold it against them too much. I don't know. I guess maybe you could pull off another upset here, but I don't like him.
The 9th race at Indiana Grand Saturday night. It's the DRF Bets race of the day. Let's take a look and see where Mike and I landed. Mike, you're going to go with Title Ready. I have to be honest with you. He's the kind of horse, like you say, at that morning line, he's a very, very square price.
Yeah, I don't know if you're going to get to 12, but I just felt like maybe he could be an okay price in this race. I didn't really know where to go, Matt. I do like King Zachary. I don't want too short a price on him off of that just, you know, one race or one figure in him. I think his other races are good. They're just not that fast. I just wanted to take a shot. I don't love anybody else in here. I'll give Title Ready one more because I do think he had a little bit of an excuse last time.
Yeah, this is one of those tough ones for me where I actually like King Zachary, but he's going to be a horrific price. He's not going to be a playable price in this spot. So I'm just going to pick him and hope that he gets through this. And you know what? There's a part of me that hopes that he actually backs up that 98 or comes close to it, because then all of a sudden it becomes interesting down over the summer, whether it is up at Saratoga or a race like the Pennsylvania Derby or elsewhere. So Mike's going to go with the number 7 Title Ready. I'm going to go with the number 8 King Zachary in the DRF Bets race of the day, race number 9, the Indiana Derby. You're playing the Indiana Derby or any of the other races from Indiana Grand on Saturday, again, head on over to drf.com/bet. You get all the latest details as far as a new sign up is concerned with a DRF Bets account. drf.com/bet is the address. Scheduled post time for race number 9 Saturday night under the lights at Indiana Grand is 9:48 Eastern. Best of luck.